Welcome to my channel PM Biology. In this video, we are going to talk about multiple alleles. Now, the term allele is very much familiar to you. The genes, when they are present in two alternative forms, they are known as alleles. Now, the term itself tells you what kind of allele it is. It is a multiple allele, means multiple. Why it is called multiple? Because there are more than two types of genes are present or alleles are present, and in that case we can call them as a multiple allele. More than two types of alternative forms of genes, when they are found in the chromosomes, they are known as multiple alleles. And here we will also see one example, that is ABO blood group system in human beings. So let's get started. Now, this multiple alleles, there are more than two alternative forms of a gene in a population occupying the same locus on a chromosome or its homolog are known as multiple alleles. So the multiple allele definition is given. In short, more than two alternative forms of a gene. So just now I told you what is the meaning of this multiple allele. There are more than two alternative forms. When we call alleles, there are two forms of alternative genes. They are known as alleles. But here multiple means more than two alternative forms are found in the population, and they are occupying the same locus on a chromosome or its homolog. So they are known as multiple alleles, right? Now, these multiple alleles, they arise by the mutations of the wild type of a gene. So how they arise, the question comes in your mind, how they are formed in the body or in the chromosomes. They are formed because of the mutation of the wild type of a gene. Now, this multiple alleles, the genes mutate several times, and they produce a series of alternative expressions. So while mutating, they mutate several times. During mutation or during that process, they change themselves and they form a different or a series of alternative expressions. Different alleles in a series show dominant or recessive relation, or may show codominance or incomplete dominance among themselves. We have seen in the previous videos what is incomplete dominance, what is codominance. So different alleles in a series show dominant recessive relation or may show codominance or incomplete dominance. So the dominance or recessiveness is seen in the alleles here. Wild type is dominant over all other mutant alleles. So which one is more dominant? Wild type is dominant over all the mutant alleles. And multiple alleles specifically do not undergo crossing over. This is a very important point about the multiple alleles. They do not undergo crossing over, just like other normal genes. They do not undergo this process of crossing over. So here we'll take one example of multiple allele, that is ABO blood group system in human beings. We know the basic concept of ABO blood group system. The ABO blood group system is present in the human beings. That means A type, B type and O type of blood groups are found in all human beings. But what is the basic concept behind this ABO blood group system, that we'll see in this video. So the gene, basically gene I, is controlling the ABO blood groups, and it has three alleles. So see this carefully, how many alleles it has. The three alleles are found: IA, IB and small I. The alleles IA and IB produces slightly different forms of the antigen and alleles I. This allele I does not produce any antigen. IA and IB, they produce antigens, but small I do not produce any kind of antigen on its RBC. These this forms the different types of phenotypes and genotypes in the blood group system. So we know humans are diploid organisms, and therefore each and every person is possessing any two of the three I gene alleles. So every person or each and every human being has two forms of this genes, that is I gene allele. So here IA and IB are codominants and are dominant over small I. So these two IA and IB, they are codominants and they are dominant over I. And there are six genotypes and only four different phenotypes. How many genotypes are found? There are six genotypes and only four phenotypes are found, and therefore we get the following types of blood groups in the human being. So here in this table you will see the genotypes as well as the phenotypes which of the blood groups of human beings. So here in the first column, genotypes, either IA, IA will be the genotype, or IA small I will be the genotype of the person. And in this case, if such combinations are found in the genotypes of that human, then that human being is having blood group A. Secondly, if the genotype shows IB, IB, or another combination will be IB and small I, in this case only the phenotype or the blood group of that person will be B. If the genotype is IA and IB, means these alleles are found IA and IB, then in this case the blood group of that person will be A as well as B, that means AB. And the last case is if that person do not have the genotype IA or IB but only having small I, small I, in this case the blood group of that person will be O. So this is all about the multiple alleles with an example of blood group. I hope you understand this point, and definitely we will see the basic concept of this ABO blood group system in the next video. So thank you so much for watching, and if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.